cite any five salient features of ICBN. Some of the salient features of ICBN, the generic name is a singular noun. The first letter of generic name is always written in capital. The specific epithet is an adjective and is always written with small letters. It is derived from many sources and may consist of one or more words. Example, Oryza sativa or Oldenlandia albonervia. The name should be short, precise and easy to pronounce. The binomials are printed in italics or underlined. The generic and specific epithets are underlined separately. Example, Abutilon nilgerense or Abutilon nilgerense. When new names are given to any plant, then the herbarium preparation of the same specimen with its original description is preserved in any recognized herbarium. This herbarium specimen is denoted as type specimen. It is to be preserved on herbarium sheet. The person who publishes the description of any plant for the first time or giving a new name to a plant is considered as author. The name of plant should bear the author's abbreviated name at the end of specific epithet. This is called author citation. Abbreviations were made for eminent taxonomists. The name Linnaeus was abbreviated to L or Lin, Robert Brown to RBR, and Sir Joseph Dalton Hooker to Hook. Example, Malva sylvestris Linn. The original description of the plant should accompany by the Latin translation. If naming the plant is from a source of error, it is regarded as ambiguous name. It is also called nomen ambiguum and is completely ignored from use. If the generic and specific epithets are the same, it is called tautonym. Example, sassafras sassafras. Such names are not accepted in the system of nomenclature. Bring out the significance of herbarium. Importance of herbarium. Herbarium is a source of knowledge about a flora of a region or locality or a country. It is a data store in which information on plants are available. The type specimens help in the correct identification of plants. It provides materials for taxonomic and anatomical studies. Typical pollen characters have been well emphasized in taxonomy. Morphological characters of the pollen remain unaltered even after storage up to nearly 200 years. It is very much useful in the study of cytology, structure of DNA, numerical taxonomy, chaetonomy, edit, chemotaxonomy, etc. It acts as a reservoir of gene pool studies. Because of its importance, several herbaria have been established at the national and international centers.
Please subscribe our channel for more videos and educational contents.